So I decided to sort of start doing some Q&A videos. I hope this goes well. I asked you to ask me any questions, and here are the answers to the questions. Let me start with the Twitter questions, because I just took questions on Twitter. Okay, so Car John Mann asks, would you mind taking us through the journey of home automation if you're into it? Also include where you get the corresponding devices conveniently. Okay, so I've reviewed only one smart gadget for home automation. That's the doorbell that I got from ITB Connect Kenya. I've spoken with them and they are planning on opening a store for smart gadgets and all that. And I believe their solutions are really good, but I'm not very much into smart systems and smart automation for the home and all that. I only have a Google Mini speaker for switching on the TV and switching on the light bulb. That's the Philips light bulb that I got from Xiaomi's event yesterday. And an Android box. So that's the level of smart automation for the home that I'm into. The Philips bulb is from Xiaomi because it's made for Xiaomi. You don't have to use the Philips mechanism to access the smart features. The Android box is Xiaomi Mi Box S on a TV and a Google Mini, that's all. The doorbell, I used it for a couple of days, but since it's pretty hard to get into where I live and all that, it made no sense, and there's already a doorbell at the door, a normal doorbell. But the smart one, I'll link the video because you can see who's at the door and all that. Kissy Kenny Smart asks, do you think Huawei will be on the winning team as it is now with the new OS if they go live without Android? I think Huawei should stick to making their own operating system, because I think they have learned that their business can be really hurt by a decision from America. I know they have said that Hongmeng OS is not actually becoming a smartphone OS and all that, because currently it seems that like the ban will be reversed for certain products like Android and all that. But I think Huawei should stick to building their own operating system, because it keeps them at a higher place. It makes them secure from other factors that will affect them. And I think most companies that have the ability should do something about having sort of their own operating systems, because America is proving to be a country that cannot be relied on for trade and all that with their current political issues. I think Huawei is still on top. Whichever way the ban goes, they can hurt a little if the ban will continue, but they're good.
Westside Onyonyi asks, hi, please, how do you activate VoLTE? Because I've seen it.
So I posted that my SIM card has sort of been activated for Voice of LTE on Safaricom, but I came to realize this part of a test group or test phase period, because VoLTE is currently having issues. So everyone will receive a rollout in the future, because currently making calls and receiving calls is sort of troublesome, but in the future it will be activated for everyone. So just wait if you have a VoLTE enabled phone and your SIM card is a 4G SIM card, you will get VoLTE, and hopefully that will happen soon. Now on to Facebook.
Jireni asks, does Oppo F11 Pro support VoLTE?
I think most phones will be able to support VoLTE, so don't worry, as long as it's a 4G phone, as long as you have a 4G SIM card, and as long as Safaricom and your company sort of, because VoLTE requires a partnership from both ends, I think as long as Oppo and Safaricom agree on certain issues, or as long as Safaricom creates a certain way for most phones to activate VoLTE, it will work.
Brian Beggy asked, why do you think Xiaomi didn't launch Note 7 in Kenya?
So yesterday I attended Xiaomi's first Mi store opening. It was good, it was big, over 400 people were attending according to Xiaomi Kenya. And most of the people there didn't just come to check out the store, they came to buy and bought actual stuff. And I think most companies should learn from what Xiaomi did. Xiaomi hasn't been very serious with the Kenyan market. I've also complained about them delaying products and all that. But I think they're starting to warm up to the Kenyan market. The company behind the Xiaomi brand in Kenya is sort of getting focused on the Kenyan market. They've promised more Mi stores in Kenya and all that. So yeah, the Note 7 is available in the Xiaomi store. They have different variants at different price points. So if you want to pick up a Note 7, just walk into their store at the hub current and they'll have it for you.
Joshua asked, when you update Hive S launcher, does it disable the launcher you've installed like Nova? Or is it MySpark 2 only?
I think that's your
phone only. Elvis Munialo between note 8 and 7 plus, which one is the best all round?
I don't know which brand you're asking. If it's the Note 8 from Samsung, it's a good phone, though dated.
Joe Murray asked, best mid-range phones you've reviewed so far this year.
First one at 12K, it's the TechnoSpark 3 Pro. That's a really good phone. I love the battery life, love the cameras, love the performance. Hated the software, but it's a good phone. At 16K, 17K, the Samsung Galaxy A20. That's the absolute best mid-ranger at that price point, because an AMOLED display, USB Type-C, 4000 milliamp battery, good battery, Samsung One UI is sweet. At just above 20K, the phone I'm currently using is the Huawei Y9 Prime. It's so good, 4000 milliamp battery, USB Type-C, good display, big display.
Philip Njoroge asks, which is better between Samsung A50 and Huawei Y9 Prime 2019.
Okay, so I've hung out with the Galaxy A50 from a friend from Tech Trends. He had it for review and I used it for a couple of hours. I didn't like one thing. The fingerprint, the on-display fingerprint scanner is very slow. I wish they just stuck with a normal fingerprint scanner. Otherwise, it's a good phone. The cameras are good. The performance is sort of good from the few hours I interacted with it. And yeah, between that and the Huawei Y9 Prime 2019, I feel like Huawei is giving you more value for money because it's cheaper. The Galaxy A50 is sort of more expensive, but it depends with what you actually want. If you love Huawei, this is the better phone. If you love Samsung, you will obviously feel like the A50 is the better phone. But personally, I'll choose the Huawei Y9 Prime if I were to spend money because it's cheaper and sort of has the same performance and same specs.
Maina Martini asked, I have a question. I'm on the lookout to buy a new smartphone and my eyes catch and land on the P30 Lite. Is it advisable considering the US ban?
The US ban is said to be reversed, as I've said. If it will be reversed, it's the P30 Lite is a good phone. If it will not be reversed, the P30 Lite is still a good phone.
Elia Wangi asked, between Samsung's One UI and Huawei's EMUI, which one is the best?
Samsung's UI is the best. There's no doubt about that. EMUI looks dated. Let's wait for EMUI 10 and see if things will change, but it looks dated. It sort of copies the iPhone so much and all that, but Samsung One UI is fast, responsive, there's dark mode. There's so much good about Samsung One UI that Huawei's MUI is yet to implement, so Samsung's One UI wins. By the way, Samsung's One UI is much better for me compared to even MIUI from Xiaomi, so yeah.
Ali Kago asks,
Sony or Nokia? I think Nokia, because I don't know any Sony phones you can get in the country currently. There's just a couple of flagships on Sony. I don't remember the names, the ones with the very tall aspect ratios, but yeah, Nokia is easily accessible, has Android One, is part of the Android One programs, is assuring you of up to 3 years of updates, so Nokia.
Said Nelson asks, I've enabled LTE for my Samsung Note 9. Its setting says use LTE data for calls whenever possible, but it's not connecting.
Like I've said, Safaricom is currently having issues with LTE. I hope the rollout will be enabled soon for everyone.
Otiso Chiropol asks, tell us about your TV setup, your monitor, preferred movie streaming service, audio.
My TV setup includes a TCL 43-inch TV with the Xiaomi Mi Box S.
Your monitor,
I don't use a monitor, I just use my laptop. I prefer moving streaming service, I use Netflix and other apps like TTV and all that. Audio, I use the audio from, I don't remember the name of the company because it's from university.
Dan Tindy asked, what's your take on iPhones and iOS?
Personally, I believe Apple is really doing a good job with their devices in terms of security, in terms of software updates. And you can agree that iPhones take very good photos and very good videos. So if you want to get into that ecosystem of Apple, you need an iPhone and a Mac, an Apple TV and all that. You can get into that because you are sure of sort of really good security, especially with the logins, with data breaches and all that, malware and all that. And you also remember that all Apple products get the latest software updates very quickly.
Kelvin Banks asked, Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 versus the 845, what the upgrade?
I believe it's worth the upgrade if you want to have a device that will last longer. Yes, in terms of performance, they may look like they perform sort of the same and do sort of the same tasks in a more similar way. But if you want a phone that will last you a couple of years down the line, you get the new processor.
Faith Ruto asked after Huawei P20 visit update, the PIN option is missing. Kindly contact Huawei for that because they should help you with that. Max Olandi finally asked, will you recommend a mid-range headset from this year or a yesteryear flagship device? For example, an S8 versus an A50.
An S8 is good. You'll have better performance, you'll have better cameras, you'll have that really good design aesthetic and that good display and all that. An A50, on the other hand, is newer, runs the latest version of Android, will be updated over time and all that. So I think it's up to you to choose which one do you prefer, to have the flagship performance quality that by next year will be dated, or to get a newer phone. So personally, I'll go with the newer phone because it will last me longer than an older flagship would. Okay, so yeah, those are your questions. I'm grateful that people actually asked questions. I hope people will be asking more questions in the future. I hope I've answered everyone to the best that I could. And I hope you can share this video with friends and get people to subscribe and grow this channel, because I'm seeing people are subscribing. And I started this for fun. So yeah, subscribe.